Hi, I'm Anthony. I'm your recovery coach and your rehab coach. I'd like to talk to some of you. This is a really important video. I think it's probably the most important video that I truly hope you resonate with well. And that's your recovery and how you value it. Now, it says recovery values. What it really should say is, what's more important to you than your alcohol, addiction, weed, pharma, your current condition? What do you value? That's recovery value. You see, I'd like to really make this clear that recovery and your recovery value is really about recovering your values in life, what's truly important, and by rehabilitating, regenerating that desire, that dream, that golden glow, that silver lining in the world, in the clouds, in everything you do, the golden thread that you weave through your life that makes it worthwhile for you to want to do something that you haven't done, or that seems to be currently difficult, impossible, challenging, upsetting, or you even feel it could cause your downfall. I mean, oh my God, if you stop drinking, I mean, you might lose your friends, your job, your ability to sleep, and all these other things. You've got a lot of these warped connections with alcohol, with your addiction, with your alcoholism, that don't need to be there. You see, those issues, those problems, those worries have other causes, other concerns. The solution, I have to tell you, is not more booze. It's not booze. It's not pharma. And it's not drugs. It's not weed. Those things may have been a temporary remedy, but they are not solutions. What's worth more to you than your weed? Now, if you say nothing, well, as I was saying 20 years ago when I was giving talks to schools all across Canada, the US, even Hawaii, in order to really recover, you've got to get A, your priorities straight, but B, let's recognize who and what you are. An individual who places weed or alcohol above all other things, by definition, is an addict or an alcoholic. An alcoholic will drink, pay for drinks, and drink before they eat. In other words, if having to choose between two things, eating or family or work, they'll choose the booze. That's an alcoholic. A weed smoker, similarly, the difference between weed and alcohol is simple. Weed or cannabinols, etc., are fat or fatty based, fat soluble. They stay in the body longer, they stay in effect longer than alcohol. It doesn't wash out as quick. Therefore, apparently, people don't need it as much. And factually, a true weed addict will be toking multiple times a day and at strengths way beyond what anyone had been doing 20, 30, 40 years ago. Like, it's so far beyond, it's ridiculous. That's why we're seeing psychosis and other serious problems associated with weed smoking. I'm not here to talk to you about the perils of weed or alcohol, though. I'm here to talk to you about what you value more than your temporary remedy called booze or drugs or porn or sex or whatever it happens to be as a remedy. What do you value more? Now, I don't know that yet. I'm not here to tell you what you should value. I believe in autonomy and self-determination. I believe in you setting your own goals and you having your own dreams. Really? So what is that for you? This is essentially a free recovery coaching session. I'm here to help you answer the question. What would you rather have? If you really could have something that gave you pleasure, or that you just enjoyed doing, and you'd be happy if you were getting paid for it or not. You'd be happy if you were getting others to acknowledge you or reward you or not. You'd be happy with it, even if the family wasn't, or the, you know, work didn't demand it. You just liked doing it. Now, for me, interestingly, it's helping others. This is why I'm here, okay? I decided that when I was 5 years old. I want to help others. So in order, and I love helping others despite, if I don't get paid, I like helping others. If I do get paid, I like helping others. If I get exchange or don't get exchange. Now, I demand several things when I help others professionally as a recovery coach, because in order to achieve and attain truly remarkable, valuable results, I need your commitment. And unfortunately, or possibly fortunately, until there's some skin in the game, your skin, meaning your work, your money in the game, you don't try that hard. Now, I don't know why that is. I just know it is. That's all I know. And therefore, one of the requirements, besides filling out an assessment or, you know, replying to an application or signing a waiver, these are shows, these are demonstrations of commitment. The real skin in the game, the real commitment comes when you go, you know, I respect, I value that time with you, sorting out stuff for myself. These words are you saying for yourself. I value those times more myself than this money I gave for it. In other words, if it's $300 an hour, this is worth more than that. Much more. It's worth everything to not only determine and find these areas, these gold nuggets in your life. It's what makes you want to breathe. It's what makes you want to live and grow and do uncomfortable things and have families and do work that's really challenging, go to places that you've never been to before. Why? See people, you know, challenge yourself. See people you've never seen before. Make connections you haven't done before. Getting real uncomfortable. Why? This is recovery values. These are the values. These are the things that you truly value. This is what makes you want to go forward. What are some of those things for you? What is it? You know, you may simply have had those repressed, invalidated, ignored. Probably ignored is, for many, it's the biggest one. Had some losses. I know I've had some serious losses in certain areas. Didn't want to touch them again. Oh my God, it took years to regenerate the courage and the fortitude to actually re-tackle some areas. And I have. Some cases I got recovery coaching. The ones that took really way too long, I had no coaching, no mentorship, no assistance at all, or the assistance was a little bit dismissive or threatening. In other words, Anthony, if you don't do that, we're going to, you know, leave or something, or kick you out, right? Had some severe consequences employed to me, you know. So in moving forward, would you like to do it the nice, the fun way, which is recovery coaching, the carrot way? Or would you like it to be all stick, which means the threats? And that's not coming from me. It's coming from life. That's coming from your body. When you have cancer, when your stomach is rotting, when you can't eat, when you're so paranoid you can't talk to other people, that stick. You can either have carrot, sweet, something you're going after, or stick, something you're running away from. The stick can chase you wherever it wants you to go and control you that way. The carrot, likewise, but at least you get to choose the carrot. You get to choose where you go. What are your recovery values? My name's Anthony. I'm a recovery coach and maybe your rehab coach. Give me a call. We'll see if we can do some work together and help you get those golden nuggets and those silver linings, that golden thread in your life, perhaps again or maybe for the first time.